Come on.
Hey, if we're gonna go hard, we gotta play hard. Let's go.
All right, welcome back to Friday Night Lights, brought to you by Isabella Bank. Of course, the Hurley Medical Center play of the night is coming up. But Jason, I'll tell you what, did you stay dry?
I did, luckily, my games that I shot. Yeah. But we had weather delays across Michigan tonight. Some games will be postponed and played tomorrow or Sunday. One game delayed that I was at, but luckily I didn't get rained on when I was there because the delay was almost over with. Hemlock at Carleton delayed 30 minutes because of lightning early second quarter. And we pick it up in the second. Elijah Jackson unblocked and levels Max Dininger for a sack on third down. So it's fourth and 18 at the Carleton 21 for Hemlock. Dininger floats it up to the end zone. Bryce Murphy makes a heck of a catch for six. That could be our Hurley play of the night. Extra point ties it up. Next Carleton possession, DJ Volz rolls right. He hits Ricky Garcia on the move. Garcia breaks the tackle. He gets in. But it would be all Hemlock from there. Huskies roll 54-33.
Freeland at Swan Valley, the old friends going at it here again tonight. All right, pick it up here in the first, and Freeland's Bryson Huckabee here is going to find Jacob Gundinger here, open down the middle, going to shake a couple of tackles here, shake a couple of more, and he's just going to drive his way for 20-yard gain. Then a little later on in the second, after a score, Evan Vasek here gets the kickoff, and he is long gone, 95 yards to the house. That could be our Hurley Medical Center play of the night. It was 27 Falcons. Swan Valley's next drive, Colton Klein throws it up to Brandon Brandt here, goes up and snags it for the 40-yard gain. Later on the drive, Tyler Drain here would put his head down and push it for the touchdown, but it's Freeland winning 36-13, the final score in this one.
Bay City, John Glenn visits Essexville, Garber. Garber facing fourth and one inside the 10 early, and they are stuffed by the Glenn defense. But the Bobcats couldn't get much going when they'd have the football. Now, after this play, the Garber coaching staff and star defensive lineman Alex Van Sumeren were going ballistic over a non-call. Here's what happened as we slow it down on the replay. A Glenn player goes after Van Sumeren's ankle and just starts twisting it. That can't happen. Very next play, they would be called for a chop block. I believe it was on Van Sumeren. He was upset for multiple plays in a row there before the penalty. Garber would get the ball back. Cade Coquillard to Logan Anthony. And it would be all Dukes on homecoming, 37-0, the final.
Beale City is ranked fifth in Division 8. The Aggies hosting Manton this evening, and it didn't take long for the Aggies to start dominating this game here. Pick it up. First time they touch the ball, they get six. The pitch goes to Caden Smith, and he is going to cut up, cut out, and he has gone about 45 yards to the house. 7-0 Beale City. Second possession for the Aggies. They're going to the other side this time as Wade Wilson's going to get the corner, and he's going to ramble about 20 yards for a first down. But guess what? The Aggies would end up facing fourth and long, but never fear, because the screen is going to be here. Cade Block is going to get on the outside. He's just going to walk in. Look at that. In for the touchdown. Beale City walks off 49-0.
Let's go to Kindy North Huron taking on Carsonville, Port Sanilac. North Huron up 8-0 first quarter. Will Case runs in, and the two-point conversion would be good to make it 16-0. Then Nick Lewis fumbles, and it is recovered by Braxton Vigensky for Kindy, and that would set up this. Will Case, play action, throwing to Ryan Shornack for the touchdown. It's all North Huron. They roll 38-0.
Friday Night Lights will be back right after this quick timeout.